ready to think big thoughts about the future of computing? Then start thinking small.
Something new has to come along, basically. And the big question is, what's new? What's next?
With support from the National Science Foundation, electrical engineer Philip Wong and computer scientist Subhasish Mitra at Stanford University are working with IBM to develop a new generation of computers with processors made of tiny carbon nanotubes, 50,000 times thinner than a human hair. Bye-bye, slow, bulky silicon chips. Hello, nearly endless possibilities.
Today, you know, we have incredible computing, you know, that has changed our lives, but to be able to do more so, we need massive amount of performance. For example, today runs on a supercomputer. We should be able to run that on a cell phone.
So far, their carbon nanotube chip has pretty modest functionality. It runs this robotic arm that shakes hands. But let there be no mistake, this was a big breakthrough, years in the making. The Stanford team had to overcome some big design and device fabrication hurdles to get this far.
Even though it may be the perfect material to make the perfect transistor, the engineering challenge of how do you make them at a large scale with billions and billions of these transistors on the same chip, or even in multiple layers of the chip, how to do that is a great challenge.
Building a multi-layered chip, carbon nanotube transistors and memory devices stacked on top of each other like floors of a high-rise, is the holy grail for this team.
Today, silicon chips are two-dimensional. Just like in a landscape, you have houses and your streets and so on. What do people in big cities do? They build high-rises.
The stakes are high. Much of our global economy runs on the expectation that computers will continue to get faster, devices smaller, and costs will keep going down.
The fact of the matter is, if we don't work on it, if we don't put efforts into it, this is not going to happen.
Wong sees this high-rise architecture as a gateway to vast improvements in computing speed and performance.
And if you look forward into the future, I would say you ain't seen nothing yet. There's a lot to be done, and there's a lot being possible that we can envision.
Building carbon nanotube processors with the muscle to turn that smartphone into a supercomputer. That's a good deal. Let's shake on it. For Science Nation, I'm Miles O'Brien.